kind of a chilly day. It definitely can feel winter right around the corner.
Poor Ashley and Uncle Sam out there.
That's true. All right, retail sales showing stronger than expected results in September. According to our next guest, though, this recovery in retail is bifurcated, meaning it's like a fork in the road.
Check it out. By the way, she also she likes Urban Outfitters on the dip. She said buy Crocs and Lululemon and Decker too, just like
right. We were talking yesterday, and I said Decker with UGGs, and you said UGGs is teaming up with Jimmy Choo, so
and she likes it too.
Okay, so you got your stock picks. Actually, mm-hmm. We're gonna have more a little later on this hour, but first, talk about going viral. According to new research, an iPhone can get more germ infested than a toilet in a subway bathroom. I should note, it's not just limited to iPhones. Apparently, all cell phones with glass touch screens are vulnerable.
Yeah, let's not play favorites here, right? The study, which was done by the Journal of Microbial Biology, found that about 30% of viral material on a cell phone surface can be transferred to your fingertips. What about your face?
I don't know.
You're holding that onto your face, too.
I'm a fan of germs. It builds immunity.
It does. You're right. If you can get it at a young age, mm-hmm. Put your kids within contact of germs, then give that ironclad gut.
I still keep the bottle of Purell. It's just, and the wipes.
Mm-hmm.
It's all in balance. Everything in small doses, right? Well, do you have parents or grandparents that tell you they remember when the price of a movie was around 10 cents, a dime? That's it. Well, what if the
I'm going to change this up on the fly. Imagine walking into a Lululemon today and spending
bending
over backwards to spend $90 on some aerobics pants. And tomorrow they're $100. The next day they're $110. They go up $10 every single day.
How do you like them apples? It's called inflation, and the possibility of it happening here is more real than you might imagine. Let's
iPhone discussion that you just had in the
with
last
all
segment,
the germs
right?
and the, right. the toilet discussion. Let's
That's
move
right.
beyond that.
Let's move quickly beyond that, please. But Ben Burnham rotate out of mortgage-backed securities into treasuries. So let's take prices go up.
Yes.
But they see healthcare costs going up. They see tuition costs going up.
If they just raise by a quarter percentage point, historically that's still so low, but it's just enough of an edge up that we might get higher rates and
All right, they're killing our economy, and I mean literally. The average cost of a single murder in this country costs society more than $17 million. That's according to researchers who study the economic impact of murders, rapes, and other felonies.
That's an upbeat investigation. Yeah. The study quantifies economic losses stemming from hundreds of convicted felons' crimes. Included is the cost of incarceration, lost productivity, and pricey justice system proceedings.
Everything is more expensive these days.
Yeah. Anyone who thinks there's not inflation, look at the murderers.
Yeah, right. Look at the crime.
Well, after a week of manic market moves, we've got an expert ready to give you some portfolio and stories that caught my eye. Texting getting out of control. We've been talking about this for a long time already. Well, last month, 3,000 texts per month among teenagers. Well, now it's up to 3,339 texts per month. So that's more than 6 texts per hour that each kid is awake.
Right.
I mean,
oh,
who
yeah.
has the time?
Right.
I guess if you're a teenager, that answers
And think
itself.
Of all the germs. I mean, the Ebola virus is going to be floating around junior high schools
germs
and high schools.
Are good. Build Jeez. That immunity, as I said earlier.
All right, here's what. Why are you so surprised? We're offering you a job. I mean, don't
you're
you feel like you're qualified?
Not to worry.
Thank you very much
you're
for
welcome.
That. We got to get out of
Have
here.
Have a great weekend.
Ryan Sullivan is next after this Fox Business Brief.